Today in the workshop, we're going to be reviewing, building up and painting and doing some weathering on AMT's 34 Ford pickup 3-in-1 kit. You can build it as a stock, custom, or service vehicle. We got a lot of plastic in this box, so let's get to looking at it. We've got cab parts, hoods all one piece, we got a frame, we've got some fenders, which is going to make two-toning easy. We got all kinds of styrene. Let's get it out here in a big pile, and then we'll start taking a look, a closer look at the parts. We've got the tow parts are included to make a tow truck. We've got bucket seats, we've got steering wheel, we've got firewall parts, we've got one-piece exhaust, we got all kinds of goodies in here. You're gonna have so much stuff left for the parts blocks. Look at those sweet spoke wheels. Bucket seat, we've got 6-volt battery, springs, we got driveline, we've got dashboard, we've got all kinds of cool stuff in here. We've got the stock flathead V8. We got a tailgate with chains. We've got the box with the wood. We've got the floor pan. Everything looks lovely. Even though this kit's been reissued in many different versions, it still looks pretty good. The flash, even though it's like bigger on parts like this, is super thin. You can remove it with your hobby knife within seconds. The fenders look beautiful. They're out of shape. They're flat. They're going to be nice and easy to paint up. Cut off the sprue lugs there and you'll be just fine. The chassis looks lovely. With as many Azizas they've printed, molded, they look amazing still. We got a wheel back there, we'll hide. We got the nice hood with strong detail on the Ford and the V8 logo. Everything looks nice on there. Let's take a look at the cab. Still nice and square, sit square, not warped. We're not going to have to worry about anything like that. So they've kept the molds up really nicely. We've got some other parts over here. Some accessory parts, which are cool. All right, check this little guy out in chrome. Little trophy there. He looks sweet. We've got, ooh, you were wondering if they had those wheels in the kit, didn't you? And they do. We got 5 of the Steelies. Those ought to make a lot of you happy. We've got the cinder blocks back. We've got the trophy mount. We've got all kinds of plastic you can throw in the spare parts box, depending on how you build the truck. We got that nice tonneau cover with texture on it. We've got our clear flat glass. We've got 5 white wall or black wall tires. Those are labeled. Let's see if we can get close enough to read it. It says Firestones. We've got our standard metal axles. We don't need to take a super close look at those. We've got a nice big chrome tree full of parts. Take a nice look at that. You can see you've got your optional engine parts. You've got chromed engine parts. We got a separate modified block there. And those nice wheels. Gorgeous. To round the entire kit up, we've got a new decal sheet on there. All kinds of stripes. We've got some nice small gauges which will go in nicely. We've got customizing. We've got some name tags for service and everything. So I'm going to get everything in some simple green and then I'm going to start putting this bad boy together. We'll be back for a sub-assembly show off. It only takes a couple hours to get to the point where I'm at right now. You can see that the cab and the chassis are already fitted on there. They're not together. I just wanted to show you how really nice this kit, even though it's an older reissue, still goes together. I mean, you don't have any problems at all. So we got a bunch of parts I need to get in primer. First is the tow bar, all right, the winch, the rack, the lights that go on it. It's got a lot of detail on there. We got to primer that up and paint that. We've got that all assembled. The box, I left that big slug of sprue on there so I have something to clamp it to when I paint. Move it around. We've got our gas can, or we've got our gas nozzle and our taillight and license plate bracket on the back. That's all the assembly that the box needs, and it slides right on. We've got our dashboard. Very minimal details. We're going to paint that up. We've got our front radiator and mount right there, ready to go. We built the spare tire mount. That looks awesome. That's going to go in the front of the box right in front of the tow bar. All right. That's going to go like so. We've got our fan and our radiator hoses ready to go. Those just need to get painted. We got those assembled. I cut off as much sprue as I could to the radiator support. That goes off the front of the firewall here and will be up to the radiator. That's a very gentle part. Take it easy. We've got our exhaust ready to go. That will just get painted and slid into the frame. Our headlight brackets that go into nice locator holes on the fenders. Those are going to get painted the same color as the fenders. Our grill is a white plastic piece. Since we're going with a stock grill, that will get painted metallic and then washed so that we see detail. Our horn will get painted metallic. The battery, of course, will get painted black. The nice 6-volt there. We've got our tailgate. That will be painted body color. I did not want to attach it to the box, so I can do some detailing to the box and then at the end glue my tailgate on, and I won't have to worry about working around it. We've got that nice toolbox. That'll get painted a nice color. Our steering wheel and column will get painted the interior color. Of course, we've got our trophy stand here and our cinder blocks and our extra gas can for the bed. Those will all get painted in their typical colors. The wheels are beautiful pieces. Look at that. Really fine detailing for a spoked wheel in styrene. Those are ready to go. We've got our spare tire mount on the fenders there, so we made all 5. And you can tell that I'm going with a service truck just by what I've been talking about. Our hood is cleaned up and ready to go. We'll get on to some other stuff here. The engine is all assembled and looks lovely. Okay, very basic flathead V8. That's all glued together and will get painted as one, and then small details picked out. Now for the main components here, we've got that beautiful cab over the fenders. Let's take that up and pull it gently apart. We've got our firewall and our windshield frame. Be very careful during assembly and don't snap off your lone windshield wiper. But that looks very nice. That's all assembled, ready to go. No issues, got the firewall on there, and you can see that it fits beautifully. The interior as well is ready to go. This is a service truck. We're going to do a very plain Jane interior on it. Very plain. No extra bells and whistles on this one. We've got our fenders with our spare tire mount. That's all going to get painted a contrasting color to the body. And then we've got our chassis. Wheelbacks, metal axles are in place, drivetrain is in place, and that looks absolutely delightful on there. No assembly issues. I did put the metal axles in right away instead of waiting so that they can get treated with the same color. The engine just drops right in and lines up with the drive shaft without issue. It slides back about another 1/8 of an inch. If you don't believe me, we can get it to fit in the hole there, and there we go. We'll get the little motor mounts to line up, and that's how that's going to sit right in the frame like that. I need to get a bunch of primer on stuff and some body color. We'll come back in just a little bit. As the build continues, I like the kit more and more. We've got some cool color on a lot of the parts. I was going to do this a little bit of a beat-up service truck. It's going together so nice. It's so sweet. Now I want to do it kind of as a resto show truck, almost like an antique truck. You know, it wasn't be new, it'd be someone bought one of these and restored it. So I've done the chassis, the frame, in a nice gloss black. I've done the engine in dark green, and then we'll decorate it with hand painting. We're going to do our interior in a vinyl gray flooring, along with the dashboard will be the same color. What else we got? We got the tire rack painted, so that can just go off to the side, be placed in later. I got the body done, and that is a beautiful ivory. I went online and saw a really nice Ford 34 done in ivory and gloss black, and I just loved it. The color I used for that ivory, literally called ivory, again, Rust-Oleum, ivory, doesn't hide any of the detail, doesn't hide any of the hinges or anything, and it looks lovely. It's still got all the detail on the hood. Everything is still there. We've got the tow bracket done in a nice gloss. What else we got here? We got our tailgate. We got our radiator shroud. We've got our headlights all done in gloss black. So you can see the thing we're going with. I've still got to paint the toolbox. I've got the exhaust over there in silver drying right now. So what I'll start doing now is detail painting the engine, getting it all together with the exhaust and the chassis, getting that mounted onto the fenders here, the lower part of the body, get the body mounted, get the interior mounted in the body and all that stuff. We'll come back as always as we go. If there's any fit issues or any problems, I'll let you know right away. Now, we're not going to be using a ton of chrome parts. I'm going to be using the bumpers, of course. I'm going to be using the hubcaps, which are right there, those five, and those are going to be dull coated. I won't be using the beautiful wheels. I'll be using the headlight surrounds right there. Won't be using that nice engine grill. I'll be using the mirrors, the tow hook. There's door handles on here, right there. There's lights for the tow lights right there. So I'll be using that kind of stuff, the shifter, the brake lever, and just adding a little bit of detail to them. But there isn't a huge amount from the chrome tree that I'll be using since I'm not going to be doing a major customization. That's all stuff that can go back into the parts box. I'm going to keep working on stuff. We'll come back for another update. As usual, the final gets closer and closer. Now, if I have any issues with assembly, I would tell you. But you can see, it's looking amazing, and I just have stuff kind of pushed together. Nothing is actually glued in as of yet. We've got the cab on, we've got the hood on, that beautiful chassis, and it just looks fantastical. We can pop that off and show you some stuff on it. I did accent the Ford and V8 logos and the hood pins and the handle. I put that on there. I did a little minor detailing on the firewall, but otherwise it just as it is, with a little bit of a gloss coat on it. The bed has been done up. The chains have been accentuated. The bed, I didn't do a wood bed. I did it a factory, as if the guy kind of restored this, found it, made it up nicely so he can drive it to shows and stuff. It's not a concourse perfect 34 Ford. I don't do those because I would have to pretend to be an expert, and I am not. I've got the dashboard done. That is detailed up. Looks very nice, very basic dashboard in those. I haven't decided if I want to use these turn signals or not. What I wanted to do was I colored them yellow with Tamiya clear yellow, and I might put them on top of the cab as warning lights for the little tow truck. Speaking of the little tow truck, I've got the tow all assembled with the included chrome hook. I used a piece of wire in black to simulate tow cable so that it hangs straight and looks lovely. The toolbox is done with all the little cool tools in there. You can see some of them sticking up. You just snap them off the tree and put them in there. The nice basic interior is done in all gray, very basic, with the shift levers and the pedals. We got the beautiful trophy. That looks awesome. Just did a wash on the truck and then did a black paint inside of the flag so we can get that all taken care of. We've got the extra jumper battery done. We've got to put the door handles on. Those are left. We've got the grill done. Now, I did do it in a metallic in the grill and then wash it out because that's how I wanted it to look, with the nice little Ford hood ornament. We've got the headlights and the horn done. I did do the horn in a metallic nickel color and then did the headlights, of course, in clear. We got the gas can back here. We've got the jack back there. Oh, we got the tire rack that's going to be sitting in the front of the box like that. So we've got all kinds of cool stuff. Let's get this over here. The fenders are on. None of this is glued together, but you can see how beautiful that spare tire is going to look mounted on there, all set up once we do glue it in place. You saw how nice everything fit right on the chassis. The wheels are not glued on either, so they might fall off, but they do fit really well. We've got that nice flathead installed. We've got the exhaust hooked up. The exhaust lines up really nicely. No issues at all. Comes right out the back. And once again, those wheels and tires are phenomenal. They just look absolutely beautiful, and I wanted to do them in red because I saw a picture of one with an ivory body, the black fenders, and the red wheels, and I thought it looked really sharp, so I wanted to do it that way. We only have a few things left to go. We got to put those handles on. We got to put the glass in. We've got to glue everything together. When we come back, we'll have a nice final. Now, what I'm going to be doing is using a part from a different kit. I don't do this a lot, but I went back to my old 1950 Chevy kit. You can see that review on my channel, the AMT 1950 Chevy pickup. I found these cool Rusty's rust-proofing decals in that kit. I'm going to put those on the door. very last before we finally come back for the final. Those are in, once again, you can see the 1950 Chevy kit pickup that I did build up on the channel. I'm going to be putting those on there. These are the factory decals that come with the kit, as we showed before. I haven't used any of them because I didn't do any customizing. And I like the purple, but I did not put that on there. I wanted to go with the Rusty's Rust Proofing. Kind of a cool little idea for a guy who would restore one of these and take it to shows and have a lot of fun with it. So when I come back, we will have the final of the 34 Ford pickup build. And here we are with the gorgeous, the scrumptious, the easy to assemble and beautiful turnout of AMT's 3-in-1 34 Ford pickup in 1/25th scale. It is the old Trophy Series. You could see it right there. This is fantastical. First, just in case you weren't paying attention, the only things on this kit that were not included in the box are the two tires in the bed and the decals on the door. The license plates included. Everything you see here is in the box except for the tires and the decals. Those I got out of different AMT kits. The decals came out of the 1950 Chevy, and those extra tires came out of some random AMT kit because they're always throwing extra tires in them, and that's what's awesome about those extra parts. She is absolutely stunning. I got the flathead V8 in there. You can see what I did with the turn signals. Instead of putting them on the fenders, I thought they'd look cooler on the roof, tinted yellow. We've got the tire rack in the back with the toolbox. We've got the extra battery back there. We've got the jack. We've got the fuel can by the back of the bed. I made sure to add the tow hook. This would be beautiful going to any cruise night, any car show. It just looks fantastic. No issues with assembly. Everything from front to back, top to bottom, fits perfectly without issue. When you get done with this kit, if you decide to build it as a service truck, you're going to have tons of extra parts no matter which way you build it. But as my method, you've got all these decals left over. You've got bucket seats. You've got the beautiful five extra steelies chromed out. You got a set of extra cinder blocks for propping up other kit builds. You've got an engine stand for other kit builds, or you could even put the engine stand in the back of the truck. You've got a nice aerial. You've got an extra trophy truck and an extra jack in chrome. You've got a customized grill, air cleaners, air horns, extra mirror. I only used one mirror on this kit. I wanted to put it high and on the driver's side, but that was it. Otherwise, you've got tons of extra parts there. You've also got another set of chrome wheels that are super yummy, and an entire separate engine, smokestacks, which will work on numerous other pickup trucks, a tonneau cover, and all kinds of other stuff that's going to be left over when you're all done. This kit was an easy build. It was an absolute pleasure. When it comes around here again, we will try to get the hood off so you can see. The hood's a nice tight fit, and with the paint on it, it really fits in there super tight. You can get it off. You just want to take a few seconds to pull it off. So we'll go ahead and do that here in just a minuto. We'll go and we'll just slide it right off of like a so. And you can see under the hood with the brace, it is an absolute pleasure to build. I really enjoyed this one. This is about a 4-day build. The paints I used, of course, were the Gloss Ivory by Rust-Oleum and their 2X. I used a gray primer on the body, black primer on everything else. Just used a standard Rust-Oleum gloss black on those fenders and used black primer to coat everything else. The engine was done in a Rust-Oleum Hunter Green. Very easy to do. Beautiful kit, as you can see. This kit is available right now, and you need to get out and pick up a copy because look what you can build with that. We thank you for watching the workshop. We'll have another review up soon. Talk to you then.